Hey guys, Ravi here. At this point, you would have made or seen a lot of projects done with these Arduino boards. But sometimes, even these small little devices seem too big for some projects. That's where the Attiny85 comes in. This tiny little Arduino compatible IC is smaller than even your thumbnail. This would be perfect for projects like universal IR remotes, small LED animation setups, or any projects that don't require many resources and need to have a small footprint. The only problem is that to program it, you can't just plug a USB cable into it. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily program the Attiny and shrink your Arduino projects. The only thing that you'll need is a breadboard, the Attiny85, an Arduino Uno, and some jumper cables. I also have a 100 ohm resistor and an LED here for testing. So let's get started. Take note of the small dot on one of the corners of the Attiny. This is the corner from where the pin count starts. The pins are numbered this way. The connections with the Uno are as follows. The pins 5, 6, 7 of the Attiny connect to the pins 11, 12, 13 of the Uno respectively. Pin 1 to pin 10, pin 8 to 5 volts, and pin 4 to ground. That's the hardware done. Now, connect your Uno to your PC via USB and fire up the Arduino IDE. Select Arduino Uno as the board from under Tools. Go to Files, Examples, Arduino ISP, and select Arduino ISP. Select the correct port from under Tools and upload the sketch. Now, the Attiny is not included in the board's menu by default. To add it, go to Files, Preferences, and paste the link from the video description into the Board's Manager text box. Click OK. Go to Tools, Board, Board Manager. Scroll to the bottom and select the Attiny and click Install. When that's done, you will find two more entries under the board's menu. Select the one that has 85 in it. Then from under Tools, set the processor to Attiny85 and the programmer to Arduino as ISP. Don't select Arduino ISP. That will just give you an error while uploading. Go to Files, Examples, Basics, Blink. Change the pin 13 to 0 and click Upload. Now you can connect an LED to pin 5 of the Attiny and it should be blinking at 1 second intervals. The pin numbers in the IDE and in real life are different because the IDE sees the GPIO numbers which are as follows on the IC. Now you are essentially done at this point, but I am planning to do a few projects with the Attiny in the future and the whole process of setting up the wires and breadboard can be a bit tedious. So I decided to make the whole process even more simpler by designing a shield for the Uno that would remove the hassle of wiring it every time. I designed the layout in Easy EDA and uploaded the generated Gerber files to glcpcb.com, who are the awesome people that are sponsoring this video. You can order 10 PCBs in a variety of colors for only $2, which is a totally insane price for only a 3-day build time. Check them out if you wanna take your project to the next level. I ordered my PCBs in white just because I can and they look awesome. Soldering the IC sockets and the female headers was simple enough, but plugging in the Attiny soon brought up a few problems with my first ever PCB design. I had apparently forgotten to connect the ground and 5 volts of the Attiny to the Arduino and misconnected one of the pins. This was easily solved by a couple lengths of tinned copper wire and cutting one of the traces. I corrected the mistakes in the PCB design too and ordered another set, but they are not here yet. So there you go, the shield works perfectly. You can even use it to program the bigger Attiny 2313. The project file with the mistakes corrected would be in the description if you wish to get the shield for yourself. Thanks again to GLCPCB for sponsoring this video. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to see this shield being put to some good use in future videos.